This is the average. We talked about it in our speed reading workshop. This applies to lots of people, generally adults, but it doesn't take into account education level. For college educated adults, it is a little higher, 150 to 250 generally, 200 to 300 for the college educated. And on the screen, it's a little bit slower, 136, believe it or not. This is one of those things where the reason it's slower on the screen is because there's more potential distractions when we're reading on the screen. If I'm reading a physical book, I mean, there's no ad that's going to pop up after I turn the page. There's not going to be a link in the middle of a paragraph that gets me curious, like, huh, I wonder what that article's about. And now I open that in a tab. I read through that article halfway through. I open another link in a tab. Before I know it, I've got 20 tabs open, and I'm wondering, what did I get myself into? Not a good way to go when we're trying to be focused, but when we're reading on the screen, that's more likely to happen. And of course, there's things like the glare from the screen that affect our eyes. If you're reading for an hour on the page versus on the screen, there's going to be more eye strain on the screen. And of course, we can try to limit that. There are like these blue light glasses that kind of help with that, especially if we're on the screen getting closer and closer into the evening, it can affect our sleep. So we can dim our screen. Some screens, like I know my screen, will dim depending on the ambient light around in the room. So you could set that automatically on a Mac. I'm sure there's a similar setting on a PC. Some of our phones have that as well. So all these things to consider. We all know that your reading speed is also affected by things like, how interested am I in this? If something is boring, I'll probably read it slower.